Dear learners, welcome to my YouTube channel Dr. Israel Classes, and in this video today I will tell you about the poles of a complex function and the categories of poles values and how we can find out the residue at the poles, at the different poles. Okay, so let us start first. We will consider a function fz, and if fz is equal to e exponential z upon z minus 2, that means to find out the pole of this function, what we have to do, we have to simply put the denominator value is equal to 0, and this denominator value will be equal to 0. It will show you that if we put z minus 2 is equal to 0, it will give you z is equal to 2. What is this? This is the pole value, or this is, we can say, z is equal to 2 is a pole, or it is simple pole because it does not have any order of it. It has an order of 1. So simple pole, basically we can find out directly after putting the value of denominator equal to 0. So if we have the same function here, let's say if you have the same function but the denominator has power 2, so here it also has the pole value same. The pole value will be here z is equal to 2, but order will be 2. So if we have this function fz is equal to exponential z upon z minus 2 whole square, then we have to find out the pole of this function. So we will say that this function has pole z is equal to 2 of order 2. Simply, if we are having another function fz is equal to e to the power z upon z minus 2 whole cube, it has pole at z is equal to 2 of order 3. So these are the simple poles. And for the simple pole, we can just put the value of denominator equal to 0, and we can find out the singularity and non-essential singularity are the poles. So now next thing of this video is residue. If you want to find out the residue of the pole, what we have to do? So we cannot find out simply residue of any function by only one formula. So there are three or four formula to find out the residue of the function at the pole. It depends on the pole and the order of the poles and where we are going to find out the residue. So let's say find out the residue of the function at simple pole. So if we have a function fz and the pole value of the function fz is z naught, then residue at z is equal to z naught will be equal to limit z tending towards z naught and z minus z naught fz. We will understand better this question after taking example. Let's say this is example here, fz is equal to exponential z upon z minus 2, and what we have to do, we have to find out its residue at its pole, at its singularity. So the pole here is what, as I mentioned, the simple pole here, it is and the value of the pole is equal to 2. So we have to find out the residue at z is equal to 2. So we will use the formula here, residue at z is equal to 2 will be equal to limit of this function from and the value of limit from z to pole value. So I can write residue at z is equal to 2 will be equal to limit z tending toward 2 z minus 2 fz. So I put here limit z tending toward 2, and here z minus 2 fz was e to the power z upon z minus 2. So this term will be cancelled out, and the function remaining here will be e to the power z or exponential z. So we can put the limit here, and the limit will be limit z tending toward 2 will be e exponential z. So we are going to put z is equal to 2 here, and the value here will be exponential 2 over e square. So this is the method if we are going to find out the residue at simple pole. So this is simple method to find out the residue. So another method here to find out the residue if the order of the pole is greater than 1. So there is different formula, different tool to find out the residue in such case. So I am considering this case, let's say we have to find out the residue at pole which is order greater than, which has order of m and m is greater than 1. So what is the rule? The residue at z is equal to pole value z naught will be equal to 1 upon m minus 1 factorial, where m is the order of the pole, limit z tending toward the pole value, and the differentiation of this pole value z minus z naught power m, where m is the order of the pole fz, and the differentiation will be m minus 1 times. Okay, you can remember this formula here. And to understand better, I will give you the example here. Let's say the example fz is equal to z minus 4 in the denominator, and we can find out the residue of this function. Let's say I'm writing here, I will give you the live demonstration for this example. Let's say I have this function fz is equal to exponential z or e to the power z upon z minus 2 whole power 4. I have to find its residue at its pole. So it is very clear that the pole will be here. For pole, we can keep z minus 2 whole power is equal to 0. It means z is equal to 2 is the pole of order 4. So in such case, the residue will be z is equal to pole value 2 will be equal to 1 upon a factorial m minus 1, where m is the order, it means m here is equal to 4. So here the rule, in the rule, limit z tending toward 2 dm minus 1, yeah, it means it will be d power 3 upon dz power 3 z minus 2 power 4 fz. This is according to your formula. So I am putting the value of m here, and I am putting the value of fz. It will be 1 upon m is 4 here, it will be factorial 3, limit z tends toward 2 d power 3 upon dz power 3 z minus 2 whole power 4, and it will be e to the power z upon z minus 2 whole power 4. So this will be cancel out, and the factorial 3 will be equal to 3 into 2 into 1 is equal to limit z tending toward 2, and here it will be d cube upon dz cube e to the power z. So the differentiation of exponential z will be the same if it is first order, second order, third order. So if I put all these value after differentiating this, it will be one of here is a multiplication, so it's not equal. Here it is 1 by 6, limit z tending toward 2, and it will be e to the power z. So it will be 1 by 6 e to the power 2 e square. So this will be the residue if the order of the pole is greater than 1. Now simply we will continue this for the next case. So I have discussed about the residue at simple pole, and residue if the pole value has some order. Now I will tell you one more thing here. If I am going to find out the residue of any function at infinity, so in such case the formula is different. Let's say here if poles are infinity, then what will be the value of residue? Then residue will be what? Okay, so to find out the residue at z is equal to infinity, or when the poles lies at infinity, in that case the formula is residue z is equal to infinity is equal to limit z tending towards infinity minus z f z. If you will get the value of the residue by using this formula, but in case if you don't get the value of the residue, you don't get the finite value of the residue by using this formula, so what you have to do, so I wrote here, if it does not give the finite value, then simplify fz. Okay, if this formula fails, what you have to do, you have to simplify function fz, and we have to look what is the component of 1 upon z in that function, and the negative value of the component of fz, the negative value of the component of 1 upon z of fz will be the residue. Okay, let's consider both example here. First example here, let's say I have to find out the residue in this case. So example is, find residue at infinity for fz is equal to z upon z minus a into z minus b. So for this function I have to find out the residue. Okay, I will use the simple formula here. Residue at infinity will be limit z tending toward infinity minus z fz. So I put limit z tends to infinity, and I put here, I extend this line here, limit z tends to infinity minus z, and what was fz? Fz here, fz from this formula here, z upon z minus a into z minus b. What I have to do, I have to delete this z square from the numerator and denominator after taking the common from the denominator. So I wrote this expression as limit z tends to infinity minus z square, and I took out z from here and I took out z from here, and it will be 1 minus a upon z remainder, and here will be remainder 1 upon 1 minus b upon z. So z square, z and z will be cancelled out from this z square, and if you put the value of limit, you will get the residue will be minus 1. Let us continue to this another example here. Let's say I have to find out the residue. Find the residue at infinity for this function fz is equal to z cube minus z square plus 1. So I will use the same formula first. Residue at z is equal to infinity will be limit z tends to infinity minus z fz. So I put limit is equal to limit z tends to infinity. I put here limit z tends to infinity minus z, and z I took here z cube minus z square plus 1 upon z cube. So here this is z and this is all fz. So what I did, I took z square from this fz, so that z square and z becomes z cube, and that and this z cube will be cancelled out from the denominator z cube. So the final function here will be the remainder will be, if I take z square from here, the z will be here, and here will be minus 1, and here will be 1 upon z square, 1 upon z cube. So the remainder will be z minus 1 upon z plus 1 upon z square. If you put the limit here, you will get the infinite value. So the formula z minus z f z to find out the residue does not work here. So it does not work here, right? So I told you here, if you read this line again, if this formula does not work, what we have to do, we have to simplify fz, and the negative component of 1 upon z of fz will be the residue of the function. Okay, so what I have to do now, I have to simplify this function. The function was z cube minus z square plus 1 upon z cube. So what I have to do, I have to simplify this function, and the function after simplification becomes as 1 minus 1 upon z plus 1 upon z cube. Okay, so what is here, the residue, so the component of 1 upon z is minus 1 here. So residue at infinity will be here minus of 1 upon z component in fz. So minus 1 already here, and the component of 1 upon z is minus 1, it becomes 1. So this is the value of the residue at infinity. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoy this video, and to encourage me, please like and subscribe this video. Thank you so much.